the demand for clean energy has revived interest in nuclear power. This revival has led to new innovations aimed at better utilizing and safely managing spent nuclear fuel. Hi, I'm Ricky, an engineer here at Mouser. Welcome to Need to Know, where we break down the latest in tech to empower you with insights for deeper research and discovery. Today, I'm here to tell you what you need to know about using nuclear materials to build incredibly long-lasting nuclear batteries. Space agencies have been using nuclear batteries since the 1960s to power probes such as Voyager and both of the rovers still operating on Mars. These original nuclear batteries are known as radioisotope thermoelectric generators, or RTGs. RTGs convert the heat generated by the radioactive decay of isotopes into electricity using thermocouples, which exploit the thermoelectric effect, a process that converts the temperature differences directly into electrical voltage. These batteries use carefully selected radioactive isotopes like plutonium-238, not nuclear waste. Researchers have recently developed nuclear diamond batteries using nuclear waste, such as carbon-14, a byproduct of nuclear power generation. These small, safe batteries can last for 50 years or more, marking a significant innovation compared to RTGs. Now, that's what we call innovation. Diamond, an electrical insulator, an excellent heat conductor, is a key material in these batteries, often using electronics as heat spreader or heat sink. Researchers have recently discovered a remarkable property of diamond. It can generate electricity when exposed to radiation from radioactive decay. And this forms the basis of nuclear diamond batteries, which take advantage of this phenomenon, followed by precise engineering to ensure functionality. For these batteries to be practical, they need to be safe, cost-effective, and powerful. Here's where another key property of diamond comes into play: its exceptional ability to block radiation. By encasing radioactive material in diamond, the battery remains safe to use. The initial prototypes used nickel-63, but the goal is to use carbon-14. Extracting carbon-14 is relatively straightforward, which helps keep production costs down. The actual amount of carbon-14 in each battery has yet to be decided. But, for example, a battery containing 1 gram of carbon-14 will deliver 15 joules per day. For comparison, a standard AA alkaline battery weighs around 20 grams and stores about 700 joules of energy per gram. If used continuously, a AA battery will be depleted in roughly 24 hours. In contrast, a perfect nuclear diamond battery running continuously will theoretically take 5,730 years to lose half of its power. So yes, nuclear diamond batteries are likely to put out significantly less power than a AA battery. Mere microwatts. But that can still be more than enough for clocks, calculators, pacemakers, and different types of sensors used in all kinds of applications. And instead of replacing batteries every 10 years, you might have to replace them every 50 years. Now, building a battery you will never have to replace is theoretically possible. There you have it! Everything you need to know about nuclear diamond batteries in less than 5 minutes. Want more details? Visit our website and read this article. As always, thanks for watching, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel. See you next time.